appreciation after that second round as the local favorite Bobby Chacon came storming back. The champion Limon had him pinned in the corner and wailed away at him. He landed one good left hand to the side of the head. And Chacon covering and at the same time absorbing punishment, suddenly rose up and fought his way out of the corner and took the play away. There's the left hand right there that rattles Chacon in the corner. Now watch it. Out he comes with a right hand. And another right hand just short, but he kept throwing it. And he landed at least four solid right hand blows to the head of the champion and one good solid body shot. So Limon coming out pretty well in the first round, has the challenger come back in the second round and even things up. Round three, scheduled for 15. I don't know if it'll go that far. In all the years, I don't know that I've ever seen two fighters who are better gamers than these two. Little edge in height, the little edge in reach to the champion Limon. It is the fourth time that Bobby Chacon has tried to win a world title. Hard right hand by Chacon. Now it is Bazooka popping a right hand, a sharp one to the face of Bobby Chacon. By Limon and then a right hand over the top. That right hand jab of Bazooka. Very firm. There it is. And another one. Step back for a moment and then let go of flurry. Now he taunts Chacon a little and brings the right hand over the top. Chacon nails him with a hard right, but Bazooka comes right back with a straight left, and they're going to give Bobby Chacon an eight count. Mandatory eight count, and the judgment of the referee, Herrera, it was a knockdown, though he didn't go all the way down. Exchange, hard blows, and it was Chacon who hit the canvas. Change the right hand by Chacon and the left hand by Limon. The referee called it a knockdown and gave him an eight count. We're in round number four now. Still a very even fight for the WBC World Super Featherweight Championship. Chacon finds Limon with a good left hand, just missed with the right, and then Limon wails away at the body. Hard shots to the body. Colo Hernandez talking a lot to Bazooka. He wants him to use the right hand more. Bazooka's primary appetite is to just get in there and wail away. Oh, just missed. There's a right hand that didn't. Lateral movement by either fighter. They're just going straight at each other, and a hard left hand by Bazooka Limon as Chacon tried to duck under it. He caught him on the side of the head with it. The right hand uppercut got in. Chacon blinked. He needs to get out of that corner because Limon is letting him go. Right hand gets him again. To get out of that corner. Does with a right hand and staggers the champion with another right hand. They bumped heads. They butted. Hard butt. A really banged head. And now Chacon pressing the fight. He's got Limon backed into the corner. They really banged heads. Chacon coming on, roaring in the last minute of the round. Less than 10 seconds to go in round number four.
No son of mine.
At the close of the fourth round, here's where they butted heads, right there. Boom. And as a result, Bobby Chacon is bleeding on the interior near the right eye on the nose. It's a cut on the nose, just toward to the right eye. And it looked to me like the butt may well have caused it. Hard to say exactly because so many punches were thrown by both men in the round. This is round five. This is the fourth meeting. Each of them winning a split decision. There was a technical draw under California rules. 27 rounds they faced each other. And they're all even, and I've still got them all even. Right hand comes over the top to the side of Bazooka's head by Chacon. That's the champion facing him. Popping the right hand into the face. Chacon digging the left hand into the body. Bazooka loads one up and gets nothing out of it. Chacon pressing the fight. Now, we anticipated Bobby would have this kind of a run at him in the early going. Blood is not a problem from the cut on the nose for Bobby Chacon. Pounders. Again, not a lot of lateral movement. Boy, they're just going straight at the target. Taking whatever they have to in order to reach the target. Wicked left hand by Limon. Hard shots to the body by Limon. That Bobby Chacon has gone through some of the heaviest training of his life preparing for this fight. Because he knows full well after 10 years and 31 years of age, there may not be that many big paydays left. Winning the championship here would really help him get some recognition. That's what he wants. Because he's been a champion and he wants it again. Good left hand by Chacon on the side of the head of Bazooka at the end of round five.